everyone. Mark and Joey here at the start of a new week, Monday morning, after a great weekend of sports. Lots to talk about: golf, Indy 500. We had the basketball course, which we did our video on the Raptors. So we're going to cover that off as well. And a number of features we have coming up this week. We got the French Open in tennis. We're going to expand out into tennis. We also have a new feature we're going to do. We're going to do the top 10 sports to watch live and ones that we consider that you should only watch on TV, which for us is probably most of them. We have to say ahead of time, when you get the right TV, it's fantastic. We're going to talk about watching sports live and on TV as kind of a special feature. We're going to do some of those shows for you. You can agree, disagree, but we have seen a lot of sports live. We also watch a lot of games overall. We see what it's like to be live. So we're going to have some comments on that in special shows that we're going to do over the next week or so. But right away, let's jump into the NBA, Joe. I mean, everybody's talking about it. Still today, watching the morning news, the Raptors win is just everything to everybody. So I think it's a great place to start. The series starts when?
Thursday.
So we've got a bit of time waiting for us here. But I do want to talk a little bit about what's going on. You have the, I had the Warriors all the way to win the championship. The Warriors, actually, Warriors-Raptors was my pick right from the very beginning. So I'm getting the series I wanted. I said the Warriors are going to win in the end. I still believe that. The only thing to this is that if we can get Durant back in the lineup, I think the Raptors will have a chance, because I think this guy is such a distraction to the Warriors that I think that that this would be a disruption that would help us win. I think it's going to be tough, though, man. They look so good in the last series, sweeping it 4-0. They got Curry leading the team again now. I think we're going to see a six-game victory for the Warriors, as much as I'd like to. You know, I will be cheering for the Raptors in every game, but kind of logically or unpassionately, I see the Warriors winning again. I think you're probably going to have a different opinion.
Well, I mean, most people are picking the Golden State in six, but people also pick Milwaukee to beat Toronto in five, most people. So, yeah. The way I'm looking at it is this. If you look at matchups, the reason why I don't want Durant is because he's still a matchup. He's still a wasted effort. You have to put a player on him. Without him, obviously, you can maybe double guard a Curry or a Klay Thompson, because that was really the key with Giannis, was you were able to build a wall against, because he had one play. People said, well, they're going to struggle against Golden State because Golden State can shoot. But also, now you can defend the shooting because they don't drive to the net. Right. That was the thing with Milwaukee. So people aren't really looking at the fact that you make adjustments, you change the style of play. At the end of the day, I think you can still hold Curry and Klay maybe to average games. They're going to never have a bad game, but hopefully some average games. And, really, there are other players who have to step up. There's a lot of key matchups here. One thing I'll point out, though, is Portland won more minutes than Golden State in that series they swept. Well, if a better team like Toronto, who knows how to close and knows how to win, if they got those same leads, I don't think they give them up as much as Portland did. I think Portland was in a situation where they're just not as good. And when they got in those moments, they'd never been there, and they really panicked. But lost a combined total of 3 points in the fourth game, 5 points in the third game, and 6 points in the second game. People look at it as Golden State's that good, they could be losing, come back, win. I look at it as, with a better team, a more experienced team, do they not give up those late leads? So I'm looking at this game. I think it can easily... I don't know if Toronto will win. I think they can, though. I think there's a strong possibility. I think this is a seven-gamer. I think this is way closer than people think. We swept the season series. I don't care what you say. We beat them by 25 points in Golden State without Kawhi Leonard. And they had Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, and Durant. The other game at home, they did not have Curry, but we still beat them, and we did have Leonard. The fact is, no one had beaten Golden State in Steve Kerr's career, swept Golden State in Steve Kerr's career. With it's the only second team to do it. So I'm just looking at matchups, and I'm looking at, no one thought we could take care of the three players on Milwaukee, but what it proved is once you destroyed the person who had the ball to begin the offense, the other guys couldn't do what they did, and you ultimately win. Same with Golden State here. In my mind, you put Leonard on Klay Thompson, you put Siakam on Draymond Green, and you put Lowry on Curry, and they got to step up and do their thing. At the end of the day, there's two players left on the court, and I like our two players better than their two players. We have Marc Gasol. I think he's been very good. Ibaka, Powell, Van Fleet. I don't see Iguodala. He's injured. DeMarcus Cousins might be back, but he's going to be a fresh piece. I just think there's more matchups.
Green has got to start scoring. I mean, this has been an awful playoff for him.
Danny Green for the Raptors, you mean, not for the Warriors.
For the Raptors.
Draymond Green for the Warriors is going to be the key, really the key player. Because you know Curry and Klay are going to put up 20 to 30. But can you win the matchup with Draymond Green? Because he'll be their third star. Really, you should have Kawhi match either one of the Currys or Thompsons. Hopefully Lowry can match a Curry or Thompson or Van Fleet or someone of that nature.
Right.
So hopefully you can match those two in points. So really, you're right, the matchup will be Draymond Green for Golden State. But the Green on our team has to get going or don't play him. Van Fleet can start. I don't understand the want to keep playing Danny Green. In my mind, I think off the bench might help him because they're leaving him open for threes and he's continuing to miss. That can't help his confidence. In my mind, you get Van Fleet out there early, you bring him off the bench, maybe in a situation where he's more relaxed now because he's not in the starting lineup.
Yeah.
Maybe he can drain a couple, but he needs to get going for sure to help his series.
Well, he was big in the regular season for the Raptors, so
yeah, I mean,
we really need him to play better off the bench or starting, whatever they happen to do with him. You know, and you see that with veteran players. I mean, they go through some struggles, but eventually they hit it, and once they start hitting it, it just goes and goes and goes. We watch Marc Gasol go 0-for-9 in one game, and the next game he's 5-for-9. So this happens once they get in a bit of a rhythm. The Raptors.
It's been a long time though for Danny Green. It's been
sure
like
has.
A series.
Well, the whole playoff virtually. So on my end, I'll be cheering for the Raptors. I don't know that we can beat Golden State. I mean, this is unbelievable team, and you know, we'll see what happens. You are analytically looking at the Raptors and believing they can win as well as our own Packers
I just think it's
so that's good. That's a good way to look at it, and you know, nobody's invincible. You know, there's no saying that Golden State can't be beat, but they've looked awful powerful here in the playoffs, and you know, the Raptors are going to have to be top notch.
Here's my thing: Clippers took them to six. Houston took them to six, and Portland took them to six. And quite honestly, they've lost. They lost most minutes to Houston, lost most minutes to Portland. And with a better team, which hopefully I'm thinking Toronto can continue what they've been able to do, can they be the team to grab those leads but then not give them up? At the end of the day, it hasn't been that dominant as far as like game-by-game wins. Now, people believe that's just Golden State and they're that good. They can do that. That might be true. But if I'm looking at optimistically and a little bit of hope, obviously, that Toronto can make this a really good series, there's the potential there that if Toronto can learn how to hold leads and get out to early starts, Golden State's not started well. My biggest fear is neither is Toronto. They've both been horrible at the start of games.
Who's going to go up with a good start?
It'll be interesting, but I just think there's ways to get it done. This is Golden State's fifth straight finals. Do they wear down at all? They are banged up. They're lucky, not lucky, but they swept, so they got a lot of rest here, which was the worst case scenario really for Toronto. But I'm just looking at it going, hey, man, Clippers took them to six. They weren't even supposed to be a playoff team. Then you got Portland who led at halftime in every game.
Yeah.
You're supposed to be better than all these teams, Toronto. Can you turn a couple of these games? You get home court to start it off. Got to get game one. And hopefully 1-1, maybe 2-0. If you have 2-0 to start, that could obviously be something.
Well, and that can happen for two reasons. One is, you say, home court advantage. Toronto's been great at home. Secondarily, the rest is good for the body. But the timing might not be there, too, coming into game one.
Well, and Toronto gets that good middle, you know, little bit of rest, but not too much
rest.
Right,
and we're going to be pumped. The city's going to be pumped. It's going to be a tough city to come in and play. Very good possibility. This will be the first time in a series like this that Toronto's going in with the home advantage. Obviously first time in a final, but against such a good team, to have a home advantage is massive.
And Golden State hasn't been on the road to start an NBA Finals, I don't think, this whole time, because Cleveland always finished really second or third in the East.
Yeah.
They never really won the East. So really, Golden State at home court this whole time. I'm really looking, like, this game one in Toronto could be, obviously, it always is a big deal, but the deal, like, you get home court.
You gotta win now.
Golden State's not used to it. You should be still hot. The city will be in it. I think you have to have game one. If you get game one, I think this series is very possible to go the distance. Like I said, they talk about Milwaukee, like they were the greatest. I remember people say Milwaukee was too good for Golden State.
Yeah.
So if that's the case, then how come the rap on the Raptors is six if they're lucky?
The one thing, it's always when you're new going in against a team that's been there five times. I mean, you know, so that's
why Leonard's been there, though.
So, but the one thing that I will give the Raptors, their defense has been huge in playoffs. I don't think that Golden State's played a defense as strong as Toronto's in the playoffs.
I tell you, man.
Siakam, that would be one good thing.
Siakam and Leonard alone can really slow down Curry and Thompson. They could really make it a game of the rest of the guys on the court. And that's why I was saying I could see it. I could see Leonard matching one of their guys. I could see Lowry matching one of theirs. And then And then all you really need is the other three guys out there. Who's going to win it? As it is, well, in most Gasol's series,
great on defense too. A big man. That's what I mean.
The defense of Toronto. I mean, first of all, they had the ways to do it in the regular season. They could do it again. They have the length. They have the power. Obviously, it's going to stop Curry from ever, if he ever got comments from so far out that defense doesn't matter. That's a different story. But assuming you don't allow that, I think what this showed is the length and the defense of Toronto can really play havoc for Golden State. And honestly, beat him up a little bit. You know, when they come into the paint, you know, the Raptors were really hard on Giannis. A lot of fouls. Curry's a great free throw shooter. I don't know if you want to do that.
Yeah.
But maybe bang him up a little bit.
He's not the one driving the net anyway.
So. No, that's what I mean. So really, you're playing a bunch of guys who are going to shoot from three. Rebounds are going to be long, so that's going to be important. But you could slow that down. And with the defense of Toronto, they play tight as soon as you reach half. They're not a team that plays back and allows you to come into them. I think it's going to be a lot more interesting than people think. Obviously, it's going to be a game, though, where one of them goes off, Curry or Thompson, and you're going to lose that game. So can you win a game when they're both average? Those are the games you're going to have to win when they put up 25 points.
I think, without a doubt, they're both in the NBA final. I mean, this is really what it is. The East is not as easy as it was to get through when LeBron was doing it. So this is not a weak Toronto team going up against
Golden
State.
Well, LeBron got there as a one-man juggernaut, too. I mean,
And they brought in Gasol halfway through the season. It really shored up their defense. He can shoot when he's really good. He has his off games. But he can put some threes in for a big man. It's amazing. And, you know, so they got a chance. I'm still thinking Golden State's going to do it. But there's enough reasons on the other side to think Toronto has a shot against. I would say, even against LeBron's teams, this is probably the toughest team Golden State faced in the final. Even against, all, as you say, a one-man team in...
And even when they came back from 3-1, it was really more like, it was just meant to be like, Golden State had the 73-win season, and even the team before had a 73-win season did not win the championship.
Yeah.
It was just like... It was like someone wrote that season. But every other season, you're right. Golden State's had it pretty easy with these LeBron teams because, to be fair to LeBron, he has not had a ton of help. It was a one-man juggernaut team. This is their... I think they'll be their toughest test because of the effort on both ends of the ball. They don't get that very often. And when it comes down to it, Toronto's bench actually is better than Golden State's bench. There's not a lot there right now because the older Golden State bench is a little banged up. So it depends how healthy they can get. But... When it comes down to it, it's going to be stopping Curry and Thompson. And if you do that, you cannot allow that game to go away. And that's why I'm saying if you can hold them to 25 points, you have to win that game, period. If you can hold them that. Because they're going to have a game where they go to 30, 35, and they go off. So you got to hold them. I think we can. I just look at the defensive matches. I look at what Kawhi was able to do to Giannis. But really, the underrated performance of Siakam on Giannis. Siakam on all these, on Lopez, on Middleton, and even Lowry. I mean, he's just a pit bull. He can take Curry. Curry's 6'2", 6'3", so Lowry's a little smaller. But as far as physicality go, I'd say Lowry has that upper hand, so can he be physical on Curry if he's the one guarding him? I just see all these defensive matchups, and I saw what defense did to Milwaukee. I think it's possible.
I'd like to see a taller guy on Curry because he's going to shoot a lot from
three-point.
So to have longer arms in the air blocking those shots could be big. That's the only thing I have a worry with Kyle there, if he's the guy, is he's too short to really get in Curry's way when he's shooting those threes. I'd like to see one of the taller guys out on him all the time. Obviously, he's a great dribbler, can move the ball and get open. But I think we got to be more in his face so he can shoot those
threes. If I'm Nick Nurse right now, I'm immediately putting first game to spook Curry. I'm putting Kawhi Leonard just to chase
him around.
Yeah, to test him, right? Just to see, like, what are you going to do against my best defender and the best defender, ultimately, people would say, in the league? What are you going to do against him? That's the first thing I'd do. Yeah. I'd put Siakam on Thompson, and I'd put Kawhi on Steph Curry, and Kawhi has the reach advantage. And then you put Lowry somewhere else, maybe on like an Iguodala or Livingston, because they're more role players.
Right.
So you don't have to worry about them going one-on-one with Lowry that much. And if they do, I'd take that percentage all day long for those types of players. You got Gasol on Draymond Green. Like, I'm already tasting a couple wins for the Raptors here with these matchups, but that's the first thing I'd do. If I'm Nick Nurse, first thing I'm going to do is Steph Curry, you're the man. I'm pointing Kawhi Leonard, who's ultimately what people are saying, the best player in the playoffs right now. Best two-way player, great defender, the claw. I'm putting him on you. He's got the height advantage, Leonard does. Can you score on my guy? And that's where I'm going to live and die. Because at the end of the day, you got to stop Steph Curry because everything flows with him. And the one thing I'd also say here, which I noticed in the Milwaukee series, was momentum. And what gets Golden State going? Watching Steph drain these impossible threes. So you got to stop that. It was like, what got Giannis and the Milwaukee Bucks going? It wasn't the fact if he scored a layup. No, it was if he threw down an emphatic dunk that got everyone else going. So they have their things. So don't let him shoot these big threes. That's the first thing I'd do is let him, is, hey, Curry, this is your chance. Shine or die. Because he's never faced a defender like a Kawhi Leonard.
I agree 100%. And the other thing I think the Raptors do have is an advantage. Losing by big numbers doesn't bother them at all.
Yeah, that's
true. Game two in Milwaukee, they get blown out and come back.
They're better almost.
Four in a row. So if those, you know, Curry and Thompson, those guys have that big game and blow us out by 20, it doesn't bother the Raptors at all.
No.
It's an amazing ability to come back after games like that. And like you say, there's probably going to be a game within a series, maybe two, like it was with Philadelphia, where those guys are so hot, you just can't stop them. But it's great that it doesn't impact the Raptors. So as a team that can stop momentum, I would say the best I've ever seen of a team who can stop momentum, even though they get blown out in a game, they can go back home and win. They went and won four in a row after getting blown out. After losing game one closer, they should have won. 17-point lead.
Yeah.
They blew that game. They got blown out. Most teams would have gone back and lost in five or even four.
Well, and here's, I'm glad you mentioned the Philly series. You want to look at the Philly series. We won game one. We got blown out in game two and three.
Yeah.
And then still came back and win. But that's a very potential way to go on state series and go, guarantee you what, you're probably going to lose game three. First game back in Golden State, it's one of those games a lot of the way teams lose.
Yeah.
But those games fours, Toronto has been 100% clutch. And if they get game one or game two and you leave 1-1 out of Toronto, you can't be disappointed. But the ability to possibly leave 2-0. But more importantly, if you get to game seven, you're coming home. And what that showed against Philly is that home court maybe gets you that bounce in the end of the day to win game seven.
Yeah.
That home court got us game six against Milwaukee. And ultimately allowed us to come back when we were down 17.
Well, I would say, and you probably know this better than I do, but I would say this is, I mean, you might have mentioned actually that this is the only final in the last five that they would have been on. That
yes.
Warriors are on the road.
Yes.
And they're not at home game seven.
Right.
So that's massive if we could take
not
the game
at home
seven.
In all the crucial games. Think of all the crucial games, game five and game seven. I mean, when you look at all the stats, whoever wins game five and seven, a lot of times win the series. Well,
going game seven, they do.
Well, yeah, sorry. That's what.
That's 100%.
100%. I was on that one. But for real, though, the game series clinching games, game five, they say 84% of teams who win game five win the series.
Yeah.
Or maybe 94%. And then obviously, if you win game seven, you win game seven. Toronto gets those games. That's a huge advantage that no one's talking about because our crowd and traveling to Toronto is not easy. All you need to do, man, is split home. I wouldn't even be too worried. I think you split on the road, and then you get a best of three, and you get two at home. There's no excuses not to be in this series at worst. If you're going to lose, let's make it do or die to the end in game seven. But I really have more faith than other people. I think other people will have faith, but one thing Toronto does is what? They play when they're not expected to play.
Yeah.
They weren't expected against Milwaukee. They almost do better. You say they get blown out, they play better? I think it's because they go take all the relief off them, all the pressure off them. They go, hey, we just got blown out. We're down 2-0. And they come back under the radar and prove everyone wrong. You're going to do that again in Golden State. There's going to be a game to get blown out. Toronto's too resilient. I think they've been through the ringer. Golden State has not been through the ringer in five freaking years.
Yeah.
It'll be interesting to see. And when Kawhi Leonard played for San Antonio, they were about to knock Golden State out of the playoffs until Kawhi Leonard got hurt at halftime, didn't play the second half. They gave up a 30-point lead.
Yeah.
So Kawhi Leonard can defend anybody.
Yeah, I agree 100%. So that's our first look at it on a Monday. We got four more days to go before that the big game happens. We won't run a show every day if nothing new's happening.
No.
We don't need to ramble on about the same things like some of the shows
we'll talk
do on
if
TV.
Durant is
but if
like,
we hear things.
Yeah, because right now I'm hearing he might not play.
I heard that this morning too.
Yeah.
He may not play at all.
He might not play at all. DeMarcus Cousins, though, is
coming back.
He's practicing full. What does that do?
Yeah.
If they get develop chemistry, that's a big problem.
Yeah,
he's a beast. But if he maybe causes bad chemistry, then we'll take it.
But also, you know, as everybody's talking about too, it takes a bit of time to come back off injuries no matter what.
Yeah.
So you can interrupt the sequence. You may not be playing that well. A bunch of things can happen, interjecting a guy in the middle of the playoffs. So it's going to be able to interest to see what
but
happens.
If they get something going with him, you got a rebound and he's tough to...
And just to wrap this up, if you didn't see our Raptors win show, I did a whole bunch of video about the crowd. If you've not watched a Raptors game at home, with the crowd outside in Jurassic Park, it is insane.
Right.
It's not just the people in the stadium.
Right.
Matter of fact, outside's more rowdy. However, I will give Toronto credit, which is always happens with us. No violence.
Zero arrest.
No, zero arrest. That's just Toronto. We're just chill. We're so happy to see our team win, but we're not crazy. So I was pretty impressed. When I heard that the next morning, with all those people in one place. I mean,
they said
in other cities,
they
come out of an arena and make it happen. They're already out there in this insane atmosphere of winning that game.
No arrest.
And inside the stadium, coming out into the Jurassic Park, no arrest, no damage, all that kind of stuff. So kudos to the Toronto fans for making that a great celebration to win that series. Same thing happened with Philly, just a real chill celebration. Everybody just happy. So that's Toronto. If you've never been here, and we're hoping it's Toronto again because that means we'll win. So I don't know if I want to see
60,000 people in the street, man.
Yeah, and 60,000 coming out of the arena.
We didn't even win the title. When Golden State wins the title, it's thank you.
Yeah.
If we win the title, we'll go so bananas. Like, we should win it just for like.
Well, 1993, the Blue Jays won the World Series. Yeah. 1967. Yeah, I think it was 67. It's so long ago, except I was alive. The Leafs won the Stanley Cup. We're now waiting for the Raptors, who 25 years have never even gone to the championship. So we are starved for this to happen.
Hey, real quick.
And we're looking for it.
Does this mean Kawhi stays? If you bring a parade to Toronto, I believe he 100%. I think he's already stayed. And I think he got emotional when he saw the fans.
Yeah.
And I think, in my personal opinion, he's staying now that he got to the NBA Finals. I have no doubt.
Well, the talk has gone away completely about him leaving.
I think
all that has gone away. No one's saying, oh, he's going here, he's going there. I think everybody right now in the sporting world believes he's staying.
Right.
Even our president, who we've told is leaving, we told doesn't have a contract, was tremendously emotional the other day.
He'll probably stay now, too.
Obviously,
now
he made the trade that is making this happen. And we'll have a discussion, by the way, which my son and I did for about an hour after the game, where I happened to say, this team's no better than the team we've had for the last 4 years. And the Kawhi Leonard fans went crazy. But I did have a sportscaster agree with me later on.
He said the team was better.
I don't want to go too far. We're going to have a separate show talking about, is this team better than other teams that Toronto has had who had to go through LeBron every series? So that's probably another half-hour conversation. We're not going to do it on this show, but we will come back and have that conversation over the next 4 days to take a look at Raptors past, Raptors now, and is this team really better than the old teams, except for the fact they didn't have to see LeBron. So we'll leave it at that. We'll talk to you during the week about more NBA.